My father was an Air Force Vietnam era pilot, and my mom was in the ROK Army. And I learned about the military from them, but it wasn't until one specific moment that something definitely changed. It was the 75th anniversary of Pearl Harbor. That was the first time I went to their museum, and you could just tell that that was a different type of day. Admiral Harris was talking, and something about his speech really just struck a chord with me.
Our nation is blessed to have strong men and women with exceptional courage who are willing and able to step forward to do whatever it takes to defend America whenever Lady Liberty is in jeopardy.
I want to be able to make an impact the way that he just impacted me. We moved to Hawaii in 2009. It was really hard for a while to make friends, so I threw myself online. I had a big interest in gaming. Purdue had the first computer science program in the entire country. So while I was at ROTC school, I got an email from one of my lieutenants, and it was an email for cyber warfare engineers. Cyber warfare engineers make products and tools specifically in the realm of cyber warfare. A lot of the stuff that we focus on is binary exploitation or reverse engineering. It's a very mentally taxing job.
All of Ethiopia, most of like Uganda, Rwanda, and all of
it. Just throwing your head at code for hours on end. But the absolute like euphoria that you get on the other side of it once you figure it out is incredible. And the best part about it is you have so many intelligent people around you who can help. We are all there for the same reason. Knowledge and expertise does not discriminate. The next major conflict will have a cyber component. We need a cyber force. What I'm doing is really making an impact, and it's fulfilling me professionally, personally, mentally. It's exactly what I want to do. I have this niche skill set, and I work on computers all day, but at the end of the day, like, I still love to just play video games. I'm extremely lucky that my job is also my passion. GG. I love being able to work with some of my best friends. There's only 7 women in the CWE community. We're all coworkers, but as soon as we step out those doors, 20-some-year-old girl is hanging out. I wanted to be a pioneer. And not only that, I also wanted to show young women that they can succeed in the sector. I'm still in awe of all the things that we do. It's really exciting to think that I still have an entire career ahead of me to do this. And at the same time, it's equally terrifying. My name is Marie Oberlin, and I'm a cyber warfare engineer in the United States Navy.